Hey guys, this is Mark. In this video, I will start introducing you to the logic part of applications built with UI Builder. The logic is going to be built without any coding. It is all visual, drag and drop. Any logic that you put into the application in UI Builder will actually be running on the client side in your mobile or web application. In this video, I will not go a whole lot into the actual process of creating logic. I will give you an overview of how it works, and then additional videos, we will start delving more into the actual logic building as to how you use the Codeless system, how to program algorithms, how to hook logic into various events that occur on the page. So those videos are going to be further down the line. But here, let me just give you an overview of how logic works generally in a UI Builder. I will start with a very basic demo that is demonstrative enough of how logic works, but I believe completely useless, although some people may find it useful and may start using what I'm going to show you in their applications, although it doesn't look very pretty, I might say. So what I will do is, and it's something that I do in most of the applications when I try various Codeless systems, the very first thing that I want to do is I want to add a button. And I want to add a click event, like when I click on this button, I want an alert, a pop-up to show, or something happens. So now we have a button, and let me show you how to add Codeless logic to the click event of this button. So whenever you select a component in UI Builder, whether it's the button right here, or here's a block, or entire page, notice there is going to be this little icon right here, and that icon, or you can also click the icon that is going to be in the toolbar, it always looks like a little piece of a jigsaw puzzle. But with the button, select the button, and here's the icon on the right, and then there is an icon in this little toolbar right here. So when you click on this icon, we switch to the logic interface. And this logic interface is really just a tab right here, and this tab is always present, so you can switch between user interface and logic. And whenever you go into the logic interface, what you see right here on the right hand side is a list of various event handlers and just handlers in general associated with the specific component. In this case, the component is button. Notice that there is an item here that says on click event, and when you move the mouse over, it says this event is fired when the user clicks the mouse or taps the component. In this case, that component is the button. So how do we add logic to the on-click event? It's very easy. Notice there's a green button. When you move the mouse over, it says add logic. Click that. And now we are in the Codeless editor. And this is the environment where you can actually add logic. So now that we are in the editor, let's add the logic of just displaying a pop-up. So if you go into under UI library, you will see a category device API. And there is going to be a block that says show alert, and there is a message. And then in here, let's just start with the traditional hello world. Done. So this is the logic. And the way you read this interface, there is a little block that says on click event. Anything you put inside, and it could get more complex. And I have seen applications where it gets very complex with a bunch of different logic blocks. In our case, it is something very simple. All we do is we show alert when the click happens. Let's take a look at how it works. Go into preview. This is our page, and let's click the button. There you go. We have our alert, hello world. So it is as simple as this. How useful it is, perhaps it's more useful just to see how logic works, like when you do something in the interface, and then there is a logic that executes the instructions that you provided. What kind of things you can do in the Codeless system? Keep in mind that under UI Builder, there's the whole backendless platform, which provides vast capabilities of a very generic and super rich backend system. So there you have in the entire database. So everything that you can do with the database, it is available in the Codeless system. You can retrieve data, you can update existing objects, you can create new objects, run queries, delete objects, create relations, load relations. All those things are possible. You can retrieve data from external sources. So if you have a URL from some third-party API, you can retrieve data, you can submit data to an external system. So let's say if you have something running somewhere in WordPress, you can definitely integrate your Codeless logic and your UI Builder application with it. You can register new users, you can update users, you can do pretty much everything with your users. You can send out emails, you can send out push notifications to your users, you can run geolocation queries, upload, download files, copy them, move them, delete files, because there is an entire file system that comes with your backendless application. And you can create your own API services and work with your API services right from your Codeless logic in the applications built with UI Builder. How it works, let me give you a very quick overview, but we will not actually be building any logic just yet. So in here, whenever you're editing an event handler or just a handler, and I will specify the difference between the two, there is a subtle difference, but anyway, whenever you're editing a Codeless logic, right on the right-hand side, you see various categories and then subcategories. So for instance, for system, you have these subcategories, logic, loops, date, and so on. Each of them, if you click, you get various blocks that do certain things. And these blocks are grouped by the functionality that would be associated with logic. So here you have the if statement, you have comparison, you have the negation, you have various things. Like with loops, you can create different types of loops. With math, it's all the mathematical blocks, and so on. So with timers, you can create timers on your UI pages. You can create variables, and so on. Under backendless, these are all the capabilities that exist in backendless. So when I was talking about integration with a database, under data API, you will see here that there is a block to retrieve data from the database, or get object count, or work with object relations, so or doing bulk create when you can create multiple objects. For instance, with the file API, you can see that there is a block to read files, delete files, rename, and so on. So in short, everything that backendless can do, and backendless provides a ton of different APIs, for pretty much every single API, there is a block that you can use to tap into the backendless system. So this is very feature-rich. Outside of that, if you were to just to program various logic, and then any programming language must contain at least assignment, it must contain for loop, and it must contain condition. So as long as you have those three elements, you can pretty much program any logic. And in our Codeless system, you can definitely do assignments, you can do if statements, and you can do loops. So it really qualifies as a complete system where you can express pretty much any kind of logic. And in here, under system, you will find all those things. The process is as simple as just dragging out a component and connecting it with other components just to create some kind of flow. So to summarize everything that I just said, the key thing to keep in mind is that for every single component that you have on your UI Builder page has either handlers or event handlers or both. You can add your logic using our Codeless system to describe what needs to happen, and you can communicate, the components can communicate with each other. That will also be described in another video. And you can use backendless APIs, and you can use, by the way, you can use the API services that you have in backendless. This is more of an advanced subject, but it is also definitely possible. I hope you found this useful. This is a very first introductory video into logic in UI Builder. The whole domain of logic in the UI Builder is huge. There are a lot of things that can be done. It could get rather tricky, but I find it kind of very entertaining to actually build logic using this model, because once there is no code, and it's actually quite fun to figure out the most elegant way to program your logic using this visual paradigm. Thank you for watching this video, and as always, happy Codeless coding.